the jungle below our feet. This is a meadow from below. Doesn't it look pretty simple at first sight? Each plant uses its root system to obtain nutrients like phosphorus or nitrogen.
Well, and at second sight, how do the roots obtain their nutrients? Is it so easy to reach them?
To liberate nutrients from the soil matrix, roots exude carbon-rich substances. These substances provide food to many bacteria. For them, root systems are like huge green oases in the nutrient-poor soil. The direct environment of roots is therefore teeming with bacteria. Some of them even support the roots in liberating soil nutrients.
But there are other soil microorganisms. Are the roots using only bacteria for obtaining nutrients?
Many plants not only feed bacteria, but also fungi. In return for the carbonaceous compounds, fungi make distant nutrient reservoirs accessible to their benefactors. Such symbioses between plant roots and fungi are called mycorrhizas.
And how do the fungi obtain these nutrients?
Fungi too are secreting carbonaceous compounds for easing access to soil nutrients. Again, numerous bacteria are benefiting from this action and, again, some of them support fungi in liberating soil nutrients.
This is very interesting, but is it of practical relevance?
Plant, fungal and bacterial exudates and remnants are forming the material basis of so-called humus. Carbonaceous material within the soil with a high storage capacity for water and nutrients. Given this storage capacity, humus is essential for soil fertility. At the same time, humus stores a large amount of carbon and therefore impacts global levels of carbon dioxide.
In summary, plants are using fungi and bacteria for extracting nutrients from the soil. This activity, in the long run, results in the formation of humus. This doesn't appear very complex to me. Is there something else?
Well, for sure. Mycorrhizal fungi, for example, usually colonize more than one single plant, this way connecting several root systems. The rules for nutrient exchange in such networks are largely unknown. It has already been demonstrated, however, that even plant-derived carbon may be transported by mycorrhizal networks from one plant to another. There are even parasitic plants able to tap into such networks, thus living from material produced by other plants.
So there are below-ground networks facilitating nutrient uptake and transfer of resources. But I guess there are many other things.
Of course there are. Here we can only show a very small part of the jungle below our feet. I hope it is sufficient, nevertheless, for demonstrating the complexity of this jungle.